La Bamba was one of the first cross-cultural hits, a rock cover of a traditional Mexican folk song that hit the top 40s in 1948. It dominated the American dance scene afterwards. Guantanamera was a Cuban song that reached new popularity when covered by American singer Pete Seeger in 1963, and by the Sandpipers in 1966 when it hit the Billboard Hot 100 chart. It has been covered countless times since, and is considered the unofficial Cuban national anthem. Eres Tú, the only Spanish original to hit top 10 on Billboard, reaching 9th, was the runner-up in the Eurovision Song Contest in 1973. It was then eventually translated into English and has been covered countless times since. Freddie Fender was a Tejano artist of the 1970s, where his hit Before the Next Teardrop Falls combined Nashville crooning and Mexican melancholy. Conga was an English language take on Cuban ballroom that exploded on American radio in the 80s, cementing Gloria Estefan's status as a cross-cultural icon. Macarena was a song by Spanish duo Los del Rio and was remixed by the Miami group The Bayside Boys, and it topped the charts in 1995 and 96, putting it at number 7 on Billboard's all-time top 100 songs after spending 14 weeks topping the charts. Achy Breaky Heart, Billy Ray Cyrus's debut single and biggest hit before his appearance on Old Town Road, was released in 1991, but was covered by Caballo Dorado in 1994, completely in Spanish, as the song No Rompas Más Mi Pobre Corazón. And it continues to dominate DJ booths at celebrations in Mexico to this day. Suavemente, bésame, que quiero sentir tus labios besándome otra vez. Suave, bésame, bésame, suave, bésame. Elvis Crespo's hit, Suavemente, was the first merengue track to top the Latin Billboard chart, and a bilingual version peaked at 84 on the Billboard chart, also being the first merengue track to do so. Selena's Amor Prohibido, released in 1994, was one of the first major Tejano crossovers to come out of the scene. Referred to as the Queen of Tejano Music, her contributions as a Mexican-American artist made her one of the most celebrated Latin entertainers at the time. Her music became very popular in the US, and likely would have reached more fame as she was releasing her first English album, but she was unfortunately killed as her career was kicking off. Ricky Martin's song, Livin' La Vida Loca, was released in the late 90s and is referred to as one of the big milestones of the Latin pop explosion. One of the biggest Latin acts of all time, Shakira's first ever English language hit, Whenever, Wherever, was recorded in 2001 and had both a Spanish and English language version.
Enrique Iglesias, known as the King of Latin Pop, released his first English-language song, Bailamos, for Will Smith's film Wild Wild West, and hit number one. His first English album single, Be With You, would also debut at number one in 2000. Gasolina, released in 2004 by Daddy Yankee, helped reggaeton become an international trend, a song that is still played for its danceable hooks. It would be remixed with features from rappers Pitbull and Lil Jon. Released in 2007, the collaborative song Beautiful Liar by pop queens Beyoncé and Shakira peaked at number one, won Best Pop Collaboration at the Grammys, and Record of the Year at the Latin Grammys, a successful fusion of Latin and R&B styles. Released in 2008, Lady Gaga's single Alejandro was a Latin-inspired pop single, with the title and subject of the song being inspired by Mexican vocalist Alejandro Fernandez. Miami-based Cuban artist Pitbull released I Know You Want Me, Calle Ocho in 2009. It was his first US hit from his debut English album, previously having released three Spanish-language albums. He would go on to collaborate with countless artists, both Spanish and English language, such as Christina Aguilera, Kesha, Enrique Iglesias, and more. Enrique Iglesias would go on to continue to break the US charts in 2010, releasing several singles from his ninth album Euphoria, his first bilingual album. I Like It, featuring Pitbull, reached number four on Billboard, and was featured on Jersey Shore and would become the theme song of a Mexican telenovela of the same name. Tonight I'm Loving You, featuring rapper Ludacris, would also peak at number four, and charted internationally, and was exclusively released as a digital download in the US. The top-selling Latin track in the US for both 2011 and 2012, the reggaeton hit Danza Coduro, featuring Lucendo, was a huge success for Don Omar. Hoy Tengo Ganas de Ti was a cover of a song from 1976, covered in 2013 by Alejandro Fernandez, featuring Christina Aguilera. It hit number 5 on the US Latin Billboard charts. Released in 2017 by Luis Fonsi featuring Daddy Yankee, Despacito would be remixed to feature Justin Bieber, with the remix charting number one internationally and the first primarily Spanish song to do so since Macarena in 1966. It is the longest reigning number one single at 16 weeks and the first Spanish song to be certified diamond. The music video also became the first video on YouTube to reach the milestones of 3, 4, 5, 6, and 7 billion views. It inarguably set off the next boom of Latin music in the US. Despacito, quiero respirar tu cuello despacito. Deja que te diga cosas al oído, para que te acuerdes si no estás conmigo. Estamos rompiendo la discoteca, la fiesta no para apenas comienza. Mi Gente, a 2017 remix by J Balvin of Willie Williams' Voodoo song, became the first all-Spanish song to hit number one on Spotify, and would be followed by a remix with Beyoncé. Willie Williams, Beyoncé. I Like It, released in 2018 by Cardi B, features Bad Bunny and J Balvin, and samples hit I Like It Like That by Pete Rodriguez. It was the first song on Spotify to reach number one led by a female rapper. Following his popular features and Super Bowl appearance, Bad Bunny's all-Spanish album, Yo Hago Lo Que Me Da La Gana, debuted at number two on the Billboard charts, the first all-Spanish album to do so. Released in 2019, Tusa by Colombian singer Karol G featuring American rapper Nicki Minaj quickly became an international hit, charting at 42 on the Billboard chart and the first number one by two female artists on the Hot Latin Songs chart, peaking at number one in various countries and the longest running number one of Argentina at 25 weeks. Holla, holla.
voz en la escalera, alguien cruzando el pasillo.
Having previously been featured by J Balvin, Spanish-based artist Rosalía released Malamente, a flamenco pop song, and her first single from her second album, which earned 5 Latin Grammy nominations and won 2, and brought her into the international spotlight. She would go on to later collaborate with rapper Travis Scott on TKN, her first single to reach the Billboard charts at 66.